Well, what better way to celebrate 2015 than with 15 new ways to see Charlotte?
This morning, we welcome Laura White. She's the Director of Communications with the Charlotte Regional Visitors Authority. Laura, good morning to you. Thank you so much for being here today.
Happy New Year, guys.
New Year.
You have all kinds of great ideas from the January issue of this wonderful magazine, Charlotte Happenings, and from charlottesgotalot.com. And you just always remind us that there's so much going on here in our lovely city.
There is indeed. And new year, new resolutions. Why not make a resolution to explore your own backyard a little bit more?
I like that. I like the sound of that. Let's start with dining, some new restaurants to try.
Exactly. We broke this out into dine, drink, and discover. I feel like I'm always eating bringing cocktails to the show. But
you have a good job.
Exactly.
Yeah, it's a good job.
Everybody loves a good new restaurant. I had a chance to try Dogwood Southern Table over the holidays. It's from Dressler's, their creators. It is fabulous. It's a spin on Southern favorites with a new flair. It's really terrific in South Park.
And it's called what again?
Dogwood Southern Table.
Okay, so everyone try that, all right.
Okay, and what about getting my libations on?
Yeah, exactly. Well, there's a couple new spots to help you do that. We've got Treehouse Whiskey and Fork in South Park as well. And that is, it's kind of like the clubhouse you never had except with pulled pork and bourbon. It's really delicious, lots of fun. And then there's also Passion 8 has the new location in Elizabeth. We love Chef Luca, always really delicious. He's got a new chef's table for seated for 10. So you can bring a big party and have a lot of fun and see all the action right up close.
Oh, and if you haven't been to Passion 8, you have to go. Chef Luca really is just, he's an artist and he is just a lovely, lovely man and such a great chef. The food is incredible.
Exactly.
It's incredible.
And you know, Charlotte's hops are definitely tops. We are creating more breweries by the boatload. So we have even more to look forward to in 2015. We've got a new Sugar Creek Brewery location in South End. They took over the old Mecklenburg location, so you can even do kind of a brewery hop in the South End neighborhood.
Yeah, it's a fun place to go. It's a fun place to go. Getting back to the new restaurants, did we skip any? Were there any others that you wanted to mention?
Yeah, there's a couple too in NC Music Factory. So days like today when it's so cold and you don't want to walk far, but you want to experience a couple new places. There's Taxicali, that's a new Mexican restaurant. And there's also 8 Sushi as well.
See, now I can get down with my sushi. Oh, I got my ill. What?
Okay. I tried that Texacali salsa though. It's fierce.
Oh, is it?
It's good.
All right. Okay. So we talked about dining, drinks. You said discover. That's
discover.
Another thing that the magazine is looking at this month.
Exactly. You got to break out of the backyard, change up your old watering holes where you typically take the kids. There's lots of new places. There's a new place actually in Daniel Stowe Botanical Garden called the Lost Hollow, and that is an amazing park. It's kind of modeled after, if you've ever been to the Green uptown, very whimsical, very fun. It has a lot of that. It's got an aviary with birds. It's got a pond there, lots of meandering trails. So lots of fun for the kids when it warms up, of course.
Yeah, maybe not today, but it is a beautiful, beautiful place.
Exactly.
And kids really, it was designed really with kids' imaginations in mind to get them inspired and to get a sense of play so that kids get out of this and go out and explore and discover.
Exactly. And there's also a great new market at Valentine Village. It's the 3-H Market. And so that's great for days like today. It's open Tuesdays and Saturdays, actually. But it's indoors. They have local produce and locally made foods. And they also have a lot of great gifts. And all of the inventory changes regularly. So definitely worth checking out as well.
So they bring in different vendors?
Mm-hmm.
That's what they do?
Exactly. Changes up. So every time you go, you never know what to expect. There's always something new.
Okay, the NASCAR Hall of Fame.
NASCAR reigns supreme this month. A lot of people don't know with no races on TV, but this is where we crown NASCAR royalty. We've got the induction ceremony on January 30th. We took a really interesting look at NASCAR and the induction ceremony itself. There's a lot of cool facts that a lot of people don't realize. You know, the inductees get their custom blue blazer, kind of like the Masters, the typical green, but they are produced at Taylor Richardson Conyer in Phillips Place, and they're gorgeous. And we also looked at some of the things you might not expect. Last year we had Miranda Lambert and Blake Shelton show up, special guest appearance.
Wow.
Along with all the NASCAR royalty that we all have come to know and love.
There's even more in the magazine. You can pick up a copy of Charlotte Happenings at Food Lion and at Harris Teeter. You can also visit charlottesgotalot.com. charlottesgotalot.com, a great website to go to if you need some ideas of stuff to do. Laura White, great to see you. Thank you.
Thanks, guys. Happy New Year.
You too. All right, still to come this